So today we have interesting topic to discuss, but first I want to ask you a question. Do you ever feel tired and wonder why? Well, what if I told you that fatigue and feeling tired all the time may not necessarily be just something that is normal? What if I told you that there are several serious diseases that can manifest as fatigue? While there are plenty of resources online suggesting remedies and supplements for fatigue, in this video, my main focus will be shedding light on five serious underlying medical conditions that often present themselves primarily as fatigue. Now, it's important to know that each of these conditions require a distinct treatment approach. So if you are someone who feels tired all the time, you will definitely want to stick around and watch this video. Before we get into specific conditions, we need to better understand how to separate normal fatigue from pathological fatigue. In other words, when should we be concerned about being tired and lacking energy? To differentiate between normal and pathological fatigue, we need to consider factors such as duration, severity, and impact on daily functioning. Normal fatigue usually occurs after a period of physical or mental exertion and often resolves with a rest or sleep. Now, pathological fatigue, on the other hand, can persist even with adequate rest and sleep, and it can interfere with daily activities and quality of life. Other symptoms that may accompany pathological fatigue include weakness, dizziness, difficulty concentrating, and unexpected weight loss. Now, the conditions that we will be discussing today are not listed in any particular order of significance. So let's jump into the first one. Have you been told that you snore at night, or perhaps your partner snores at night and occasionally pauses their breathing or even gasps for air? Do you wake up with a headache or dry mouth? Are you experiencing difficulty with concentration or memory? All of these symptoms can be associated with sleep apnea. Now, it's important to know that not everyone with sleep apnea will experience all of these symptoms, and some people may not even realize they have this condition. So what exactly is sleep apnea? Well, it's a sleep disorder in which person's breathing repeatedly stops and starts again while they sleep. This happens when the muscles in the back of the throat fail to keep the airway open. This leads to brief interruptions in breathing that can occur many times throughout the night. The result of this can be severe fatigue during the day. If left untreated, sleep apnea can lead to a variety of complications such as high blood pressure, heart disease, stroke, depression, memory loss, and daytime sleepiness. Just as a side note, sleep apnea is actually one of the hidden and less obvious reasons why many patients who are being treated for high blood pressure cannot successfully control their blood pressure despite being on multiple medications and even taking them as prescribed. Now, moving on to another reason for fatigue, let's talk about anemia. Anemia and fatigue are commonly associated with each other. Anemia occurs when the body doesn't have enough red blood cells or hemoglobin to carry oxygen effectively to the body's tissue. Oxygen is required for energy production in the cells, and when there isn't enough oxygen reaching the cells, it can result in fatigue. In addition to fatigue, there are usually other symptoms that may be present when the fatigue is related to anemia. This shortage of oxygen to the brain can lead to dizziness, lightheadedness, or feeling faint. An individual with anemia may also experience shortness of breath or have difficulty breathing, particularly when engaging in physical activity. Others may also notice that the person's skin is paler than usual. The person can also notice that their heart may be racing and beat more rapidly than usual. This is again in response to lack of oxygen. And lastly, because there is reduced circulation, the individual's hands and feet may feel cold. I want to stress, however, that anemia can have various causes. Some are related to nutrition, such as lack of iron, vitamin B12, or folate, but some can be due to blood loss, such as when women have heavy menstrual periods, or sometimes even due to chronic diseases, such as autoimmune diseases, which also can lead to anemia. Therefore, it's essential to speak with a healthcare provider to determine the underlying cause of anemia and to receive appropriate treatment. Treating anemia appropriately will resolve the fatigue and tiredness. Now, the third common reason for feeling tired and fatigue is chronic fatigue syndrome. Now, chronic fatigue syndrome is a complex disorder which is characterized by extreme fatigue. What's particularly special about this kind of fatigue is that the fatigue doesn't improve with rest. It is also frequently accompanied by other symptoms such as headache, joint pain, and difficulty concentrating. Chronic fatigue syndrome is a difficult condition to diagnose because there are other medical conditions that have similar symptoms. To diagnose chronic fatigue syndrome, healthcare providers must perform thorough medical evaluation, which may include blood tests, imaging studies, and other diagnostic tests to rule out other potential causes of fatigue, such as anemia, thyroid disorder, or infections. This is why chronic fatigue syndrome is known as diagnosis of exclusion. What that means is that diagnosis of chronic fatigue syndrome is made based on the presence of a set of specific symptoms, including severe persistent fatigue that cannot be attributed to any other underlying medical condition and that has lasted for at least 6 months. If no other medical explanation for patient's fatigue can be found, and if the patient meets the diagnostic criteria for chronic fatigue syndrome, the healthcare provider may make diagnosis of chronic fatigue syndrome. However, once again, it's important to know that chronic fatigue syndrome is a complex and poorly understood condition, and there is no definitive test or biomarkers to diagnose it. Now let's talk about the more serious causes of fatigue, and that's cancer. Fatigue is a common symptom of many types of cancers, including leukemia, lymphoma, and lung cancer. Cancer-related fatigue is often quite severe. This kind of fatigue is not the same as typical tiredness that people experience after a long day or strenuous activity. This kind of fatigue is a persistent and overwhelming feeling of physical, emotional, and mental exhaustion that is not relieved by rest. Sadly, in many cases, this severe fatigue may be the first symptom that brings the individual to see their healthcare provider. In these situations, the healthcare provider may conduct basic lab tests to identify any abnormalities, which may lead to additional tests and diagnostic procedures. It is important to note that cancer-related fatigue can be a result of cancer itself, cancer treatments such as chemotherapy, radiation therapy, or surgery, or other factors such as anemia, pain, sleep disturbance, or depression. Now, the last condition that I'm going to mention today in relationship to fatigue is disorder of the thyroid gland. The thyroid gland is a small butterfly-shaped gland located in the neck that produces hormones that regulate the body's metabolism. Thyroid disorders such as hyperthyroidism and hypothyroidism can cause fatigue as well as a variety of other symptoms. Hyperthyroidism, in which thyroid gland is overactive, occurs when the thyroid gland produces too much thyroid hormone. This can lead to increased metabolism and range of symptoms including fatigue, weight loss, increased appetite, sweating, nervousness, irritability, and palpitations. Now, hypothyroidism, which is an underactive thyroid gland, on the other hand, occurs when the thyroid gland does not produce enough thyroid hormone, which can cause slower metabolism and range of symptoms including fatigue, weight gain, decreased appetite, dry skin, hair loss, cold intolerance, and depression. As we just mentioned, fatigue is a common symptom of both hyperthyroidism and hypothyroidism. However, what's important to remember is that in addition to fatigue, individuals with thyroid disorders may also experience other symptoms such as changes in weight or appetite, mood changes, and changes in heart rate or body temperature. It's important for individuals who are experiencing persistent fatigue or other symptoms to speak with their healthcare provider, who may recommend thyroid function tests to evaluate for thyroid disorders. If thyroid disorder is diagnosed, can often be managed with medication or other treatments help alleviate the symptoms, including fatigue. Now, in conclusion, feeling tired and fatigue may not always be a normal condition, as there are several serious diseases that can manifest as fatigue. Factors such as duration, severity, and impact on daily functioning can help to differentiate normal from pathological fatigue. Sleep apnea, anemia, cancer, chronic fatigue syndrome, and thyroid disorders are five common conditions that can cause fatigue and require medical attention for proper diagnosis and treatment. Now, I want you to understand that there are many other conditions that can cause fatigue. Some of them, like lack of sleep or poor sleep quality, stress and anxiety, depression, sedentary lifestyle or lack of physical activity, dehydration, or even poor diet, are much more common than the ones I mentioned today. Therefore, it's essential to speak with a healthcare provider to determine the underlying cause of the fatigue and to receive appropriate treatment to resolve it. Don't just buy some supplements and vitamins and hope your fatigue is gonna get better. We hope you enjoyed this video and learned something new today. If you like the video, don't forget to give us thumbs up and subscribe to our channel to receive notification when we post our next video.